This is Fox 26 Morning News at 9 a.m. Connected to you.
Hair loss in women is not just about genetics. It can also be caused by things like divorce, smoking, or even drinking. In fact, according to one study, the strongest predictor of hair loss in women is their marital status. Another study found that women experience the most hair loss during the autumn months. Joining me to talk more about these studies and about some of the treatment options is hair restoration surgeon, Dr. Carlos Puig. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Marital status, really? What is the deal with that?
You know, I think that the stress-related hair loss is very common in women. And so when the stress of the relationship is bothersome, then it would make sense that that you would see more hair loss in those situations.
Because this particular study showed that divorced women had a higher rate of hair loss.
That's right.
So stress would be a big problem for
Absolutely.
These people.
Absolutely. It's one of the most common causes of hair loss in women.
So what can we do to control that stress so that you don't lose your hair? That's a big deal to women. I guess we just need to work on that, don't we?
Dealing with the stress is the most important thing, curing the stress. But in addition to dealing with the stress, it's also important to remember that all of the stress-related hair losses are temporary. So they'll come back in 2 or 3 years usually.
Well, so that makes women feel a little bit better, I'm sure. Now let's talk about the fall season or autumn. What does that have to do with the hair follicle?
You know, I'm not really sure that it has anything to do with it. Mm-hmm. I mean, my experience is that I see hair loss throughout the year. There is some indication that changes in temperature, because hair's primary functionality, of course, is not beauty as much as we like to think that. Mm-hmm. The reality is that hair functions to maintain your body temperature. You lose 70% of your body heat through your scalp. And so keeping your body temperature is important. So sudden changes in temperature can augment the amount of hair that you have in a given time.
Well, that makes sense. Well, just in case somebody still has a problem, you brought in a device to show with us, just FDA approved for women.
Just FDA approved within the last month, really, for women. It's been approved for about 2 years for men. Mm-hmm. Now, we need to be specific here that this device is approved for female pattern hair loss, which is the inherited genetic kind of hair loss that's associated with women. Only about 50% of the women who have hair loss have that kind of hair loss. Mm-hmm. So this device has now gained FDA approval for them. It's a laser comb designed by the Lexington Hair Max people. You use it every third day.
I'm going to turn it around a bit for our camera to see kind of how it works here.
We might even turn it on. Mm-hmm. I don't know that it's wise to shine it into the... But it's just a red laser, you can see, and you hold it in place. It's specifically designed to get the appropriate distance from the skin, so you have a consistent, even light distribution. Light's fascinating. We are finding out more and more that light has a huge thing, has a huge impact on the body, much more than we ever thought. I'm going to try to
What type of results is a woman going to see, and how quickly?
All the studies that have been done with this device have been done over a 6 to 8 month period of time. Mm-hmm. About 60%, 49, some studies 49, some studies 60% of the women who use the device slow down or stop their hair loss. At about 30% actually increase the amount of hair. The difference between the placebo group and the study group, placebo is the sham device, was almost 16 hairs per centimeter squared.
And we're out of time.
In a 6 month time.
But quickly, if somebody is interested in this and wants to find out more, what do they do?
They can find it online at HairMax, at hairmax.com, or at our website, hairrestorationhouston.com.
Very helpful information, and we know it'll make a difference in a lot of ladies' lives, so I'm glad the FDA has found something to help them. Thanks for your time, Dr. Puig.
Thank you.
Appreciate you being here.
Bye.
Well, the Texans get a big win again.